12-man squad will be representing the Rugby Sevens of Tolba Onyango in the forthcoming competition in Africa, a men's sevens competition where the Rugby Sevens of Uganda will be competing among with 13 other countries. Lux is a qualifier for the forthcoming Tokyo 2020 Olympics set for next year. And I tell you what, the big boys are back, including the two Wakorachas in Philip and Michael. I like the story the Sevens have had over the last couple of years. We talk about them featuring in last year's World Cup, I think California. We talk about them winning back-to-back Sevens title. I think that was 2016, 2017, I think so. But the brand behind Talbot's success, or the story behind Talbot's success, was built on names. Names like the Wakorachas, names like the Keremundus. And I can't ignore the fact, but the Sevens have become more successful than the 15s. And you can only hope that they can qualify for the Olympics next year.
Yeah, it's quite interesting, obviously, you mentioned. I think for me, truth be told, we've grown in leaps and bounds in the Sevens rugby. Probably we've not done the same in the 15s. And it comes back to the fact that the dynamics of the two versions of the sport are a bit different. Mm. And I've seen the squad. Interestingly, the one name that I think will be dearly missed is Solomon Okeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because of that lengthy injury that he had that throws him out of the tournament. But nonetheless, if you look at the team that actually did get to leave the country earlier today, it's a blend of both the younger and the experienced as well. And some of these players have come through a project that has been running for a couple of years. You could speak of Pius Ogena. You could speak of Joseph Aredo, the team captain at the Cubs. You could speak of players like, Aaron Ofero, who's most recently come back from Kenya at the Harlequins and resigned on for the club side that happens to be the Hima Heathen. So for me, I think it's an interesting time to be part of rugby in Uganda. And the coach Talbot Onyango is someone that understands the sport. He's been part of the growth process for most of these kids. And the hope is that we can actually put up a very good performance. Because our first game is going to be this particular Friday. We shall be playing against Mauritius. And after that, you'll be thinking that we can clinch that one spot. Mm-hmm. But countries like Kenya, countries like Namibia will be hoping to go for it. The beauty about it is that as much as we are playing in South Africa, South Africa, the hosts are not playing because by virtue of the fact that they are one of the top-ranked sevens nations in the club, they don't need to go through the qualifiers. So they qualify directly. But there's two things at stake. One is the African title for the sevens, which we've won before. And the other is a place at the Tokyo Olympics next year. And the hope is that the boys can go out there and give a good performance. So Lawrence Bukenya, Sebuliba Rather, Mike Wakorach, the team captain, have all got to come together and put in a good performance.
Well, Brian talks about the few members that were listed, of course. Ian Munyani in there included. Masa Isaac, we talk about Ogena Pius, Aaron Ofoi Wolf, Adrian Casito, Joseph Aredo, Levis Ochen, Lawrence Sebuliba, along with James Odong, the two Wakorachas in Philip and Michael, and Kevin Keremundo. This Friday, the Rugby Sevens team will be up against Mauritius. Away from that,